بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبعد الصلاة وتم التسليم على محمد وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين. Okay, welcome for this session or this majlis, and we are in the session number 19, and we reached chapter number 38. Yeah. بالأسانيد الصحيحة المتصلة إلى الإمام الترمذي أنه قال باب ما جاء في كلام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في السماء. قال حدثنا الحسن بن صباح البزار قال حدثنا أبو النضر قال حدثنا أبو عقيل الثقفي عبد الله بن عقيل عن مجالد عن الشعبي عن مسروق عن عائشة قالت حدث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات ليلة نساءه حديثا فقالت امرأة منهن كأن الحديث حديث خرافة. فقال أتدرون ما خرافة؟ إن خرافة كان رجلا من عذرة أزهرته الجن في الجاهلية فمكث فيهم دهرا ثم ردوه إلى الإنس فكان يحدث الناس بما رأى فيهم من الأعاجيب فقال الناس حديث خرافة. أوكي شام بولي دلن بحث انجليز عائشة
رضي الله
chapter
storytelling of Rasulullah
storytelling but actually at night because this was a summer when the people they sit down and they talk at night we call it summer because in Arabic countries it's very hot at the day so they will stay for a long time after Isha to you know to discussing or conversation or like that at night. Okay, yeah.
Aisha radiallahu anha reports once at night Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam related an event to his family members. One of the ladies said,
so one of the three things that you can stay at night and you can didn't sleep, the first one with your wife or your husband, okay, you can spend the time. The second for your guest, for you guests, you can stay at night. And the third one, for طلب العلم, seeking knowledge. Yeah, these three, you can stay at night. But other of these three become makruh. Makruh. Like just for talking, or right. Just watching right. TV, match, whatever. All of it is makruh.
What? Yeah. Three, what?
With wife? What? With the guests?
Yes.
Tatamu? And seeking in you, talabul ilmi. Yeah. Okay, Sham.
One of the ladies said, "This story is just like the stories of Khurafa."
So now, because of this sentence, we can say this hadith is hadith da'if. Because she said that is, you know, the hadith from Rasulullah, there is some doubting of it. Okay, like she rejected. She rejected the hadith from Rasulullah. So this hadith is hadith da'if. Just we can read it and we have some idea, okay?
The Arab use the stories of Khurafa as proverbs. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do you know what is the original story of Khurafa? Khurafa was a man from tribe Banu Udra, from the Jits took away. They kept him from some time, then left him among the people. He related to the people strange things of his stay there. The people were astonished. After that, every amazing story is called Khurafa.
Yeah, but we can say this one just like some story, maybe right, maybe wrong, we don't know. But actually there is a real story happened in Islamic University of Medina. There is one person, he came for seeking, and he is Muslim, but from Jinn. He is Jinn, and he came to Islamic University of Medina, and he went to study. Okay? But actually, always, he went to the class, and coming back, go to the Salah, pray, and coming back to the room.
Like a man?
Like a man. He is walking, actually.
Mashallah.
Yeah, I don't know. He enter inside someone. I don't know how he can... Oh. Make himself, and he was seeking ilmu. But his friends in the room, they realize there is something is coming from this person is unbelievable. For example, during winter, it's very cool, and there is after subuh, everyone he will coming back and will, you know, will go inside the cover, inside of the bed, because it's very cool. And they, each one will ask another one to close the door. Can you please the door? Close the door, close the door. No one move. And this person, actually that time they haven't partitions. They haven't just like what do you call it? Kind, some kind, and they put it in. So you can see from another side. He said, his friend. He said suddenly, his leg become is very very tall. You know, close the door and coming back. And he said,
exactly the same story.
The same story. Yeah? And he said, "Ya Allah, what's happened? I'm in the sleeping or I'm dreaming or in the life." So at 8 a.m. he went to Sheikh Abdul Aziz Ibn Baz. He tell him, "That's when what's happened." He said, "Are you realize you are in the life or you are dreaming?" He said, "I'm really in the life. I saw it by my eyes." So he said, "Okay, just follow him. Tell me, you have to have two witness. If there is two witness with you, okay, I will ask him to come and I will discuss with him." So and he asked two friends to follow him. Many things they saw from him, like sometimes they saw him is riding the bus. Okay, suddenly he was in Masjid Nabawi. You don't need to wait. It's very fast. You can arrive over there. So always like that. So they saw him is riding the car or riding the bus. When they reach Amasya, he is in the halaqa and is writing, you know. How he reach and after that he finds some place and he can write. Okay? So after that, when they saw some things, okay, they came, the three of them. They came to Amasya and they tell, "We all of you, yeah, are you Shahid?" "I'm Shahid of that." He called him, "Come." When he came, he said, "Okay, I'm from jinn. But I'm a Muslim jinn, it's not kafir. And I came here, I want to seeking the ilmu. After that, we go back and teach our people. Or our alam. And he said, "Okay, you cannot do like that. That is wrong. You can come without any body. You can attend, like in our class now, maybe someone is with us. They are Muslim and they want to hear, they want to learn. وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنِ They want to, they like to hear the Quran. So you can come without anybody, without any style. Or you can come with the, you know, with the cats or anywhere you can come. But like the human, and there is some name, he has name, you know, and he registered, and they have, you know, the over letter, and the enter officially, it's like, you cannot do like that. So he said, "Okay, please, I have to spell you from the university." So actually, that time, the sheikh is very afraid. There is the student, they will run away from the university, because that university in the beginning, just in the beginning. So he afraid that the students they will run away. So he spelled him from the university. But after that, Allahu a'lam what's happened. Okay. So this one is just like a story, and this hadith it has da'if actually. Okay, so now we can say that the talking at night is halal or without makruh for these three reasons. And after that become prevent or become makruh, huh? If you just spend the time at night for nothing, just for playing, to enjoy or like that, it's not. You cannot do. Okay. Okay, for the next hadith, it's hadith Umm Zara. Okay, hadith Umm Zara and is very, very tall. This hadith Umm Zara is too long, yeah. There is 11 women, they are sitting together and they are talking about the husbands. Okay, and who tell Rasulullah about this hadith is Aisha. She told Rasulullah about this this story. And these 11 women, they are in Jahiliyyah before Islam. Okay, they are before Islam, and you know, some of these 11, she is good and she say good things about her husband, and some of them is not good, and they are, you know, they are saying bad things about the husbands. Okay. So this hadith is hadith da'if, hadith sahih, sorry, is not hadith da'if, it's hadith sahih, because Imam Muslim, he narrated it in his sahih Muslim, so become hadith sahih. And what we will benefit from this hadith, the ghiba, okay, the ghiba for unknown person is not from al-kaba'ir and is not sin. Understood? If you want, what about the ghiba? The ghiba is haram and is from al-kaba'ir. From al-kaba'ir. Betul? Al-ghiba, talking about someone, bad things about the someone, and he is not around. What do you call it?
Gossip.
Bag?
Biting.
So that's one. The ghiba, we call it in Arabic ghiba, from al-kaba'ir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not, Allah will not padama, Allah will make muhasaba for it in hari akhirat. But if the ghiba going to unknown person is not from al-kaba'ir, because that person is unknown. At least you didn't mention his name or her name. Like you say, there is someone, he is working in UIA, and he is wearing like that t-shirt, like you are explain his character, but you never mentioned his name. So if you mention, I become ghiba. If without name, I become messy. Okay, so we will read and stop, and inshallah, Sham will follow me.
But this one is quite short.
What?
I don't know.
The first one, قالت الأولى.
The translation.
Translation is short, yeah.
What?
Can
read this, yeah.
Can.
This one. Can I
say this one? The second one.
2, 5, 3.
But translation is short.
Well,
in English,
correct?
Right?
Like he making the conclusion only.
Oh, I see.
Do you have it in Malay?
In Malay, yeah?
Okay, so you can read that?
Yeah.
Okay. حديث مزارة قال حدثنا علي بن حجر قال حدثنا عيسى بن يونس عن هشام بن عروة عن أخيه عبد الله بن عروة عن عروة عن عائشة قالت جلست 11 امرأة فتعاهدنا وتعاقدنا أن لا يكتبن من أخبار أزواجهن شيئا. عن عائشة
beliau menceritakan ada 11 orang wanita telah duduk bersama yakni dalam satu majlis lalu mereka berjanji setia untuk
berjanji ya tak ada orang akan tipu. Okay.
Untuk tidak merahsiakan sesuatu pun cerita tentang suami masing-masing.
Okay, so for this hadith, the Aisha she menceritakan kepada Rasulullah at night, because this the chapter will tell us. Okay, فقالت الأولى زوجي لحم جمل غث على رأس جبل وعر لا سهل فيرتقى ولا سمين فينتقل.
Wanita pertama bercerita. Suamiku seumpama daging unta yang kurus yang berada di atas bukit batu yang sukar didaki. Bukit batu itu tidaklah mudah untuk didaki, sedangkan unta itu pula tidaklah gemuk sehingga berbaloi, iaitu bersusah payah memindahkannya, iaitu turun dari bukit yang sukar itu.
So macam mana dia press atau dia tak terima? Dia tak terima suami. She said bad things about her husband. Okay. فقالت الثانية زوجي لا أبث خبره إني أخاف أن لا أذره إن أذكره أذكر عجره وبجره.
Wanita kedua bercerita, suamiku, aku tidak mahu menceritakan tentangnya kerana aku bimbang tidak akan meninggalkan satu pun tentangnya. Ini melainkan aku akan cerita semuanya. Jika aku menceritakannya, aku akan ceritakan segala urat di belakangnya dan segala urat di perutnya. Iaitu kiasan kepada menceritakan segala keaibannya luar dan dalam.
So she said, I don't want to tell anything because if I want to tell you, there is I need for a long time, maybe 2 days, 3 days, until I will tell you what is istighfar. But actually, from inside and outside, both of it is he is not good. قالت الثالثة زوجي العشنق إن أنطق أطلق وإن أسكت أعلق.
Wanita ketiga bercerita, suamiku bodoh tak berakal. Jika aku bersuara,
actually is not bodoh. العشنق is very tall, you know, very tall. But actually in Arabic culture, if someone he is very tall, his akal becomes small. They think like that. They think everyone who is tall, his akal becomes small. so he said is bodo, but actually he is tinggi. Al-ashanna. Okay, kalau
jika aku bersuara, yakni mempertikaikan sesuatu yang dibuatnya, alamannya akan tersalahlah aku. Jika aku senyap pula, yakni daripada menuntut hakku, tergantunglah aku, yakni tidak diberinya nafkah dan tidak perlu diceraikan, yakni sama seperti tidak bersuami.
Okay, if she talk, he will try. But if he keep silent, he will not give anything. Okay, so become her husband is not good actually. According to الله أعلم. is right. قالت الرابعة زوجي كليل تهامة لا حر ولا قر ولا مخافة ولا سآمة.
Wanita keempat bercerita, suamiku umpama suasana malam di Tihamah, iaitu suatu itu kawasan tanah rendah di antara Hijaz dan Yaman, terkenal sebagai kawasan yang sederhana udaranya, kerana itu ramai penghuni di situ. Tidak panas, tidak sejuk, tiada apa untuk ditakuti dan tidak membosankan.
So, how is her husband?
Quite good.
Average.
Okay.
Average. In the middle. He is in the middle. Okay. قالت الخامسة زوجي إن دخل فهد وإن خرج أسد ولا يسأل عما عهد.
Wanita kelima berkata, suamiku apabila masuk memasuki rumah keadaannya seperti harimau bintang, yaitu banyak tidur, tidak mengambil hirau keadaan di rumah, hanya fikir jima. Jika keluar rumah, ia menjadi seumpama singa, yaitu garang di tengah-tengah manusia, tidak pernah ingin bertanya apa yang berlaku, yaitu bersikap tidak ambil kisah.
Okay, so how?
Not good.
Also average, in the middle. In the middle, yeah, right. Because when she said, when إِذَا دَخَلَ فَهِدْ, the fight is tiger. Like or like the what do you call it?
Leopard.
Oh, what do you call it?
Leopard.
Like the leopard, he likes to sleep, but at the same time he is very strong. For the sleeping is not good for him. He's very lazy, but at the same time he is strong actually. So become average in the middle. Okay. قالت السادسة زوجي إن أكل لف وإن شرب اشتف وإن اضطجع التف ولا يولج الكف ليعلم البث.
Wanita keenam berkata, suamiku pula, jika makan, dia makan dengan lahap. Jika minum, dia menghabiskan kesemuanya. Dan jika tidur, ia membalut dirinya. Yaitu tidak menghiraukan lagi isteri di sebelahnya. Ia tidaklah berfikir untuk memasukkan tangannya, yaitu ke dalam selimutnya, untuk mengetahui keadaan atau kesedihan isterinya.
Okay, so macam mana dia?
Selfish.
So, he is good or bad? Yeah, still in the middle region, you know. In the middle. He's not good. But at least if she makes some masak, but dia agak makan. Kalau tak makan dia marah. Betul. Juga so in the middle region actually. قالت السابعة زوجي عياياء أو غياياء طبقاء كل داء له داء شجك أو فلك أو جمع كل لك.
Wanita ketujuh bercerita, suamiku pula bodoh atau bingung, tidak mampu berjumpa.
Actually, it's not bodoh. Gayaya atau ayaya, if he talk, his talking is not clear. This one is gayaya. So his talking or his words is not clear. Like that. Okay.
Semua penyakit baginya ibarat satu penyakit sahaja. Yang ini berhimpun padanya semua penyakit dan menjadi satu. Dan aku apabila bergaul bersamanya, sama ada pecah kepalaku atau luka badanku, luka tubuhku atau kedua-duanya sekali.
Ya, tak baik. Dia tak baik. قالت الثامنة زوجي المس مس أرنب والريح ريح زرنب.
Wanita kelapan bercerita, suamiku pula sentuhannya seperti sentuhan arnab. Baunya pula seperti bau arnab. Zarnab. Bau seperti bau zarnab. Ini sejenis tumbuhan yang harum baunya.
Okay, so macam mana dia? Very gentle, mashallah. Romance. Arnab, like in Arabic, haiwan, satu haiwan. You know the arnab?
Why so, gentle use arnab?
Because you know he is very soft and will play with it, and his face is nice. Okay, so she presses about him. Okay. قالت التاسعة زوجي رفيع العمادي طويل النجادي أو النجادي عظيم الرماد قريب البيت من الناد.
Wanita kesembilan bercerita, suamiku pula tinggi rumahnya, yaitu seperti rumah orang mulia-mulia, yaitu rumahnya suka didatangi tetamu. Panjang sarung pedangnya, yaitu lambang keberanian, dan banyak...
Which means he is tall. Because if the what do you call it, the short person or the short man, so he will use the padan yang short. But if he is tall, he will use the tall one. It's like that. We call it kinaya in Arabic. عظيم الرماد.
Dan banyak abu dapurnya, yani hiasan kepada suka menjamu tetamu.
So if you know pakar banya, so ada apa nama dia?
Tabu.
Tabu banya.
Abu
banya. Kalau tak ada tahu deh.
Rumahnya dekat dengan tempat bersidang orang ramai, yakni kiasan kepada orang cerdik yang menjadi tempat tumpuan orang ramai untuk bertanya pendapat, atau kiasan kepada suka bergaul dengan orang ramai, yaitu membina rumah di kawasan penempatan orang ramai.
Because if his house is very far, no one will go over there. It's very far, so he built his house nearby the Pusat Bandar. Everyone he can reach him. قالت العاشرة زوجي مالك وما مالك مالك خير من ذلك له إبل كثيرات المبارك قليلات المسارح إذا سمعنا صوت المزهر أيقن أنهن هوالك.
Wanita ke-10 bercerita, suamiku namanya Malik. Siapa pemilik harta yang ini dapat mengatasi Malik suamiku ini? Malik suamiku ini lebih baik daripada suami-suami tadi. Ia mempunyai unta-unta yang cukup banyak, tempat-tempat berteluku unta, yang ini untuk minum. Namun sedikit saja tempat-tempat pelepasannya ke padang rumput, yang ini kerana kebanyakan unta-untanya dikekalkan berhampiran kediamannya sebagai persediaan untuk disembelih bagi memuliakan tetamu. Apabila unta-unta itu mendengar suara gendang, yakni yang dipukul untuk menghalau unta tersebut, tahulah bahawa kesemuanya akan mati, yakni disembelih untuk tetamu yang datang.
Because masa yang tetamu-tamu dia datang, dia make like welcoming to them. So he will, you know, will do something, so like welcome and selamat datang like that. So kalau the haiwan dengar welcoming from the owner, they will know after this will usimbile. And at the same time he never send them outside. Will give them the food at home, because he don't want to anyone to visit him. But at the same time there is no haiwan, because during that time they haven't freezer. Understood? So they cannot put if they simply some haiwan, they cannot put it inside the freezer. So anyone will come to you directly, you will slaughter.
Is that a good husband or not?
Very good.
Very good.
Yeah. Very good. He's a good husband. Everything you can accept, every bad things from the man you can accept it except one thing, bakhil. If he is bakhil, all of the good characters or good sifat will become bad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he called shurga, la yujawiruni fiki bakhil, no one will stay, no bakhil will stay inside of you. No bakhil will enter the shurga. No bakhil enter the shurga. So if the swami become bakhil, he is very bad, you know. Even though he is very good knowledge, very good character, whatever, but accept this sifat. It's very important. If he is bakhil, never accept him. Don't give him your daughter. Never give him. If you know his father or his uncle, they are bakhil, don't give your daughter. At least. Okay. قالت الحادي عشر. Okay. For this one is coming. Umm Zara. She is talking. In the first of all, she will talk about her husband, and then for her son, her daughter, and the last one her hamba. Okay. So we'll make it divided. Okay. The first one about her husband. قالت الحادي عشر. زوجي أبو زرع وما أبو زرع. أناس من حلي أذني وملأ من شحم عضدي. وبجحني فبجحت إلي نفسي وجدني في أهل غنيمة بشق فجعلني في أهل صهيل وأطيط ودائس ومناق. فعنده أقول فلا أقبح، وأرقد فأتصبح، وأشرب فأتقمح.
Wanita ke-10 bercerita, suamiku ialah Abu Zar'in. Tahukah kamu betapa hebatnya Abu Zar'in? Dia memakaikanku dengan perhiasan-perhiasan yang banyak hingga bunyinya dapat didengar oleh telinga. Ya, ini memberiku makan hingga kedua lenganku penuh dengan lemak.
Ah, sebelum dia hayasan apa ni, macam mana? Hayasan. Dia apa? Menjerak macam mana?
Dia memakaikanku dengan perhiasan-perhiasan yang banyak hingga bunyinya dapat didengar oleh telinga.
Apa ni bunyi? Bunyi siapa?
Bunyi.
Oh ya ya. Baik. So maknanya he gives her a lot of jewels. Yeah. So she can hear it when she move. Okay. And then
memberiku makan hingga dua lenganku penuh dengan lemak, yakni kiasan kepada badan yang berisi kerana mewah dengan makan. Ia menggembirakanku hingga jiwaku jadi gembira kepadaku. Ia menemuiku dalam kalangan keluarga pengembala kambing kecil-kecilan di lorong bukit, yakni keluarga miskin. Lalu ia menjadikanku dalam kalangan keluarga pemilik kuda, unta, tanaman dan suara haiwan, yakni kiasan kepada keluarga kaya yang memiliki segala-galanya. Ketika bersamanya, jika aku bersuara, aku tidak diherdik. Jika aku tidur, maka aku dapat tidur hingga ke pagi kerana sudah tersedia khadam untuk berkhidmat. Jadi tidak perlu bangun awal pagi. Dan jika aku minum, aku dapat minum sehingga puas.
Okay. Okay, jelas ha? Jelas. He gives her everything. Food, gold, everything he gives her. أم أبي زرع فما أم أبي زرع عكومها رداح وبيتها فساح. Now she is talking about her mother-in-law. Okay.
Ibu kepada Abu Zar'in, tahukah betapa hebatnya ibu kepada Abu Zar'in? Peti-peti simpanannya sentiasa penuh, ya ini atau muatan-muatan di atas belakang untanya sentiasa berat, kiasan kepada banyaknya barang-barang dan perkakas yang dimiliki. Dan rumahnya amat luas atau lapang.
So maknanya, she has a lot of clothes and a lot of belongings. Ibn Abi Zar' فمبن Abi Zar' مضجعه كمسل لشطبة وتشبعه ذراع الجفرة.
Anak lelaki Abu Zar'in, tahukah betapa hebatnya anak lelaki Abu Zar'in? Rusuknya tirus umpama urus daripada pelepah tamar yang terkunus.
Which means he is very active. He is, you know, very active. He's not lazy. So if lelaki, he is like lazy, always he is sleeping. This one is not good for him. Have to be very active. He will move very, very, very soon.
Kiasan kepada badannya yang kurus kecil dan daging lengan anak kambing betina cukup untuk mengenyangkannya.
Tak baik kalau dia gemuk. Especially untuk anak lelaki. Okay. بنت أبي زرع فما بنت أبي زرع طوع أبيها وطوع أمها ملء كسائها وغيظ جارتها.
Anak perempuan Abu Zar'in, tahukah betapa hebatnya anak perempuan Abu Zar'in? Sentiasa mentaati bapanya dan mentaati ibunya, pakaiannya penuh, yakni kiasan kepada kesempurnaan fizikal dan kepribadiannya.
Maknanya dia gemuk actually. Ya, badan dia penuhkan dengan pakaian. Maknanya dia gemuk. Okay, tengok apa dia kata. Dia kata mil'u kisaiha. Kisai itu libas, pakaian dia penuh. Bukan dia macam very very big and she is thin. No, so she is fat until the clothes will become, you know, full with her body. So she is fat actually, gemuk. And you know the Arabs, I told you before this, the Arabs, they like the fat woman in Jahiliyyah. Not in this time, I don't know, but before that, in Jahiliyyah they like the fat woman. Like in Rasulullah, one day he entered Baytu Ummi Salama, Rumah Ummi Salama, and he heard someone, he said, لَإِن فَتَحَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ الطَّائِفِ, if tomorrow the Taif, Rasulullah opened it already, I will show you, I سأريك امرأة تقبل بأربع وتدبر في ثمان. I will show you some woman, if she came, she will came with four. And if she left you, her bag is eight. Did you understand?
No.
Me too. What is the four? What is the eight? I don't know. But means this four and eight, she is very fat. Yeah. Until the, you know, the muscles will go out and become one point. So from in the front is four. Four points is big. And from the back become eight. How is the eight? Maybe this one, and this one from the back. And there is, you can think, you can imagine. Kind of imagine. So after, when Rasulullah, he heard that from that person, Rasulullah ordered Umm Salama, throw him out the house. Throw him, I don't want him to stay at home. Rasulullah asked to throw him out. Yeah.
Menyebabkan ia dibenci oleh pesaingnya, yakni madu atau jirannya, kerana mencemburinya.
So like jealousy, all of her neighbors, they are jealousy to her daughter. Okay. Jariyatu Abi Zar'in, fama jariyatu Abi Zar'. La tabuthu hadithana tabthitha, wa la tunqithu miratana tanqitha, wa la tamla'u baytana ta'shisha.
Hamba perempuan Abu Zar'in, tahukah kamu betapa hebat hamba perempuan Abu Zar'in? Beliau tidak akan menjaja cerita kami dalam apa bentuk jajaan sekalipun.
Very important sifat. If this humble, what she saw at home, and if go back, she will tell what she saw inside home. It's very very dangerous. Okay.
Dia tidak akan memindahkan makanan kami, yaitu keluar dari rumah kami dengan apa jalan sekalipun, dan tidak akan memenuhkan rumah kami dengan apa-apa sampah sekalipun.
Okay. قالت this one is the most important, you have to know about this. قالت خرج أبو زرع والأوطاب تمخض فلقي امرأة معها ولدان لها كالفهدين يلعبان من تحت خصرها برمانتين فطلقني ونكحها فنكحت بعده رجلا سريا ركب شريا وأخذ خطية وأراح علي نعما ثريا وأعطاني من كل رائحة زوجة وقال كلي أم زرع وميري أهلك فلو جمعت كل شيء أعطانيه ما بلغ أصغر آنية أبي زرع.
Ya, yakni isteri Abu Zar'in bercerita lagi. Satu hari Abu Zar'in keluar ketika bekas-bekas susu digerakkan.
Means during the spring, because if there is a lot of rumput, so the haiwan, the beri-beri will makan. If they makan, so become, you know, a lot of susu. That means. Okay, and then?
Untuk mengeluarkan kepala.
So, maknanya, he go out during spring season. Okay.
Untuk mengeluarkan kepala susu, ini zab daripadanya, ya ini kiasan kepada keadaan yang mewah. Lalu, ia terserempak dengan seorang wanita bersama dua anak lelakinya, seumpama dua anak harimau bintang. Kedua-dua anak itu sedang bermain dari bawah pinggang wanita itu, dua buah delima, yang dikiasan kepada dua payudaranya, lalu ia menceraikanku dan mengahwininya.
Okay, actually, this meaning is complicated meaning. Okay, and until our ulama, they don't know how to explain this sentence. Is really two of the pomegranate or another meaning? Okay? Maybe it will be another meaning, wallahu alam. But he is in this tarjama, he said delima. Dilemma. But how they play with dilemma? It's difficult to understand. Usually they will, with bola, they will play, actually. Okay? Yeah. Okay, and then?
Kemudian aku mengahwini pula selepasnya seorang lelaki bangsawan yang menunggang kuda dengan tangkas, membawa lembing dari Khati, yang ini satu daerah di Bahrain yang terkenal dengan pembuatan lembing. Ia melimpahiku dengan binatang-binatang ternakan yang banyak, dan memberiku pada setiap kali pulang petang binatang ternakan berpasangan dan berkata kepadaku, makanlah wahai Ummu Zar'in, aku berilah dan berilah makan kepada keluargamu. Namun jika aku menghimpunkan semua yang ia berikan kepadaku, tidak sampai pun yakni nilainya atau kadarnya bekas terkecil milik Abu Dzar.
So she didn't she never forget about the first husband. And always the first loving cannot be equal with second or third. Okay? The first loving, the first wife, you loved her. Okay? You cannot find another wife like her. The first always become, you know, exotic. Like first time you are teaching in your class. You will never yani forget it, right? Sham, the first class, where is?
Nilay.
In Nilay. Yes. You will never forget it. For me also, in quiz, I will never forget that class. The first class after graduating. always the first place, the first entering, the first, you know, the first always become exotic. Nothing will become the same. Okay? So she never forget about the Abu Zara, the first husband. Yeah. قالت عائشة فقال لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كنت لك كأبي زرع لأم زرع.
Aisyah radhiyallahu berkata, lalu Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam berkata kepadaku, aku bagimu adalah seperti Abu Zar'in bagi Ummu Zar'in, yakni pada yakni pada sifat kelembutan dan pemurah, bukan pada perceraian.
So about Ummu Zar'a, she never forget about him because he is very mulia, you know, is very generous. And the most of his talking is talking about his generous. He never say, she didn't say about his strength or anything. Just she told about her mulia, his mulia. Okay. But actually, this riwayat is not enough for the hadith. Rasulullah, he said, "Kuntu laki ka abi zar'in li ummi zar'in." That's all. But in Sahih Muslim, there is one sentence after this sentence. غير أني أو غير إني لا أطلقك but I will not try, I will not divorce you. This one is very important because if Rasulullah said كنت لك كأبي زرع لأم زرع, so that means Rasulullah have divorced already. Okay, but Rasulullah he add, that's one in riwayat Sahih Muslim. Okay, next chapter. قال باب ما جاء في نوم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال حدثنا محمد بن مثنى قال حدثنا عبد الرحمن المهدي قال حدثنا اسماعيل عن ابي اسحاق عن عبد الله بن يزيد عن البراء بن عازب ان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان اذا اخذ مضجعه وضع كفه اليمنى تحت خده الايمن وقال ربني قني عذابك يوم تبعث عباده. You want bahasa Inggris atau bahasa Melayu? Bahasa Melayu. Okay, sambung. Pernah ni Isham, tadi dia ada meeting.
Maksudnya diriwayatkan daripada Al-Bara' bin Azib radhiyallahu, beliau menceritakan Nabi SAW apabila berada di perbaringan, yakni hendak tidur, baginda meletakkan tapak tangan kanan di bawah pipi kanan, baginda...
Actually is not this one only. Is not just put his hand with his face like this. Is not. Rasulullah, he will read the zikir before, and Rasulullah will sit down, what else, he will wipe his body before that, but he want to tell us what is the dua that Rasulullah mentioned it. So Rasulullah after reading, after zikr, he will sleep on his right side, and after that he will will repeat this dua. Okay,
dan mengucapkan Rabbi qini azabaka yawma tab'atsu ibadah. Maksudnya, wahai Tuhanku, selamatkanku daripada azabmu pada hari engkau membangkitkan sekalian hamba-Mu.
Because the sleeping like the death, right? It's same. When he slept, like he is die already. So is like there is some relation in between sleeping and death. Next حديث قال حدثنا محمد مثنى قال حدثنا عبد الرحمن قال حدثنا إسرائيل عن أبي إسحاق عن أبي عبيدة عن عبد الله وذكر مثله وقال يوم تجمع عبادك.
Maksudnya diriwayatkan daripada Abdullah bin Mas'ud radhiyallahu anhu, hadis yang sama seperti di atas, cuma baginda mengucapkan dalam doa baginda yauma tajma'u ibadak. Maksudnya pada hari engkau menghimpunkan hamba-hamba-Mu.
Like the different word. That's one tab'athu. Di sini tajma'u. Okay? نكس حميد قال حدثنا محمد وغيلان قال حدثنا عبد الرزاق قال حدثنا سفيان عن عبد الملك بن عمير عن ربيعه بن حراش عن حذيفة قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أوى إلى فراشه قال اللهم باسمك أموت وأحيا وإذا استيقظ قال الحمد لله الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور.
Maksudnya diriwayatkan daripada Huzaifah radhiyallahu anhu, beliau menceritakan Nabi SAW apabila menuju ke tempat tidurnya, baginda membaca Allahumma bismika amutu wa ahya. Maksudnya, ya Allah, dengan namamu aku mati dan aku hidup. Apabila baginda terjaga, beliau membaca Alhamdulillahillazi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilaihi nusyur. Maksudnya, segala pujian milik Allah, Tuhan yang menghidupkan kami selepas ia mematikan kami, dan kepadanya kami akan dikembalikan.
نكس حديث قال حدثنا قتيبة بن سعيد قال حدثنا المفضل بن فضالة عن عقيل أراه عن الزهري عن عروة عن عائشة قالت كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أوى إلى فراشه كل ليلة جمع كفيه فنفث فيهما وقرأ فيهما قل الله أحد وقل أعوذ برب الفلق قل أعوذ برب الناس ثم مسح بهما ما استطاع من جسده يبدأ بهما رأسه ووجهه وما أقبل من جسده يصنع ذلك ثلاث مرات.
Beliau menceritakan Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam apabila menuju ke tempat tidurnya pada setiap malam, baginda akan menghimpunkan dua tapak tangannya kemudian meniup pada kedua-duanya sambil membaca surah Qul huwallahu ahad, yang ini surah Al-Ikhlas, Qul a'udzu birabbil falaq, yang ini surah Al-Falaq, Qul a'udzu binnas, yang ini surah An-Nas. Kemudian baginda menyapu dengan kedua-dua tapak tangannya itu ke seluruh jasadnya yang termampu disapu, iaitu dengan dimulai daripada kepala baginda, kemudian mukanya dan seterusnya ke bahagian depan jasadnya. Baginda melakukan yang serupa sebanyak 3 kali.
Okay, so the first of all, in this hadith he said kana Rasulullah SAW idha awa ila firashi kulla layla, every night, which means Rasulullah never skip it, never, every night he will do. First of all, the second one, what will do? The first one, Rasulullah jama'a kaffayhi, so he gather his hands. Okay, you have to gather it, not just read it. Like you are worrying and after that you are reading. It's not. You are reading. Okay. So now, the first of all, you do it every night. The second one, Rasulullah will sit down. So if he want to read it, will not read it during standing up or during the lying down. Okay. So you have to sit down. This was the second. The third one will gather the hands. Okay? Gather the hands. Before start reading, nafatha fihima. You have to do the nafath. Nafath, there is some air will go out with some of your, what do you call it, the water?
Saliva.
Saliva. With some saliva. Like this. Okay, so you put your tongue with the lips, and after that, keluarkan air, keluarkan angin. Okay, 3 kali. So he said in the end, Sheikh Azib, in the end they will do it 3 times. So you gather it and you do 3 kali. Okay, it's not this one, like, is different actually. So you put your tongue. Okay, the third step. The fourth, you will read قُلْ أَلَّهُ أَحَدْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ رَبَّكَ لِي تِيجَ كَالِي, because in the end he said 3 times يصنع ذلك 3 times. Okay, this one, the fourth. The fifth, you will start by your hand, by your head, from the up. Okay, okay, from the up, and the second is your face, back of your head, and then in the front of your body. Okay, in the front. After that, from the back, also the back and your legs, back of your legs. Okay, this one is the fifth. Try, don't touch your awrat during wiping. During wiping, don't touch your awrat from in the front or from the back also. Don't touch it. When you reach from the back, you skip it and you go to the legs, from the back of legs, back of the legs. This one, how he wipes it, he will do 3 times. So we'll start and coming back again. Okay, the face from the back, also from the hand, in front of the hand. Okay, in front of your body. After that, you're coming back. Back of your head, back of your back, okay, and back of your hands, okay, and back of your legs. Okay, you will do that 3 times. Why? Why?
Protection.
Huh?
Is it protection?
Ah, will protect you from the shaitan, from the jinn. Okay? And after that, he will sleep on the right side, not left side. If you sleep on your left side, there is no any beneficial from all of the zikr that you have done it just now. No beneficial. Okay? Because on the left side, like you support the shaitan to disturb you during your sleeping. نكس حديث قال حدثنا محمد بن شاق قال حدثنا عبد الرحمن بن مهدي قال حدثنا سفيان عن سلمة بن كهيل عن كريب عن ابن عباس أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نام حتى نفخ وكان إذا نام نفخ فأتاه بلال فآذنه بالصلاة فقام وصلى ولم يتوضأ في الحديث قصة
maksudnya diriwayatkan daripada Ibn Abbas bahawa menceritakan Rasulullah SAW tidur hingga berbunyi hembusan daripada mulutnya, baginda apabila tidur akan bertengkur. Kemudian apabila Bilal datang ini ke masjid lalu melakukan azan untuk mengerjakan solat subuh, baginda bangun dan mengerjakan solat tanpa mengambil wuduk terlebih dahulu. Hadis ini ada kisah hadis sebaliknya dan akan diceritakan di dalam bab berkenaan ibadah Rasulullah.
Kisah dia Sayyidina Abdullah bin Abbas, he would like to know what Rasulullah will do at night. So he wait until there is one night Rasulullah will spend it with Maymuna bint al-Harith. Maymuna bint al-Harith, Umm al-Mu'mineen, she is anti kepada Sayyidina Abdullah bin Abbas, but anti susu. Okay, daripada susu. So he wait until that night and he came and he said, "Ya Rasulullah, I want to sleep with you tonight." Kan? And Rasulullah, he accept. Actually, Rasulullah, he knows what his niyat actually. There is a long hadith, but he just cut it and he tell us, or he told us what should happen. Okay? So in this hadith, قال أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نام حتى نفخ. نفخ, that is the breathing is going out, which means Rasulullah have some sound during his sleeping, but during the nafas going out, not during breathing. So if Rasulullah take the nafas, there is no sound, but when the nafas is going out, there is some sound. Okay, and this sound is not like nafakh, how is not very high sound, is low level in the low, still yani can accept it. So during the nafas there is nothing, but when this the nafas is going out, maybe some okay, like that. So during the going out, okay. عندين قال حدثنا إسحاق بن منصور قال حدثنا عفان قال حدثنا حماد بن سلمة عن ثابت عن أنس بن مالك أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا أوى إلى فراشه قال الحمد لله الذي أطعمنا وسقانا وكفانا وأوانا فكم ممن لا كافي له ولا مؤوي.
Maksudnya diriwayatkan daripada Anas bin Malik radhiyallahu anhu bahawa Rasulullah SAW apabila baginda menuju ke tempat tidurnya, baginda membaca alhamdulillahillazi at'amana wa saqana wa kafana wa awana fakam mimman la kafiya lahu wala mu'min. Maksudnya segala pujian milik Allah yang memberi kami makanan, yang memberi kami minuman, yang mencukupkan kami dan yang menyediakan tempat tinggal buat kami. Berapa ramai orang yang tidak ada orang yang mencukupkannya dan tidak ada orang yang memberinya tempat tinggal. Dan ini apabila Allah tidak mentakdirkan.
Just remember about the people who haven't food, haven't place to sleep, they haven't anything. Just think about them. Just remember. Okay. The last hadith قال حدثنا الحسين ومحمد الجريري قال حدثنا سليمان بن حرب قال حدثنا حماد بن سلمة عن حميد عن بكر بن عبد الله المزني عن عبد الله بن رباح عن أبي قتادة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا عرس بليل اضطجع على شقه الأيمن، وإذا عرس قبيل الصبح نصب ذراعه ووضع رأسه على كفه.
Maksudnya diriwayatkan daripada Abu Qatadah radhiyallahu anhu, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam semasa musafir, jika baginda berhenti ketika masih malam, iaitu berhenti untuk tidur dan berehat, baginda akan tidur dengan berbaring di atas rusuk kanannya. Apabila baginda berhenti ketika hampir subuh, baginda akan memacakkan.
Macam mana? Kalau yang pertama macam mana?
Jika baginda berhenti ketika masih malam, iaitu berhenti untuk tidur dan berehat.
Okey.
Baginda akan tidur dengan berbaring di atas rusuk kanannya.
Ah ya. Di atas? Salah. Okey, sambung lepas dia.
Apabila baginda berhenti ketika hampir subuh, baginda akan memacakkan lengannya yang kanan dan meletakkan kepalanya di atas tapak tangan kanannya.
Nah, yang pertama salah. Kalau dalam bahasa Arab, ittaja'a ala shiqqihi al-ayman. Shiqqihi, this one, the right side. So he will lie. Actually, but he said on the hands, right?
No, first.
Yeah.
On the right side of the ribs.
Macam mana? Berbaring
di atas rusuk kanannya. So means lying.
Rusuk kanan. Ah, good. Bye. So, which means Rasulullah, if there is sometimes like at 11 PM, tengah malam, okay, if there is sometimes until subuh, maybe for hours, so he will lie. But if there is no long time, like just 1 hour, 2 hours, okay, he will just will put his hand and will sleep. So the ulama, they say, which one is right, on his hand, the tapa of the hands, or on his you know what they call it, the arms? There is two tafsir, two ways, but actually in this hadith, actually on his hand.
This is by sitting.
By sitting, because he don't want to have the deep sleeping, so after that he will, you know, will lost the salat subah. Okay.
Is that right in the picture, like this one?
Can actually, but okay. This one during the first one,
the second one,
I can also. Okay, so the most important have to know that is Rasulullah, he will wake up. If there is any sound, the subah is near, will wake up. Okay, before this, there is some hadith when Rasulullah, he came and he slept at home, and Sayyidatuna Aisha, she put his what do you call it? Mattress, but make it double. And Rasulullah slept until subuh. He didn't pray for Qiyamul Layl. And he said, what do you put for me? He said, it's the same mattress actually, but just I make it double. So Rasulullah asked him to take it back. Why? Every reason, everything will prevent you to do the ta'at. You have to move it. You have to, you know, remove it first. This one also, he is very tired, actually he is musafir, and if he want to sleep, his sleeping become very deep, very strong, he cannot walk for Salat Subah. So he put some reason will make him waking up, like just sleep like this. Maybe you will, you know, sometimes you will move, so after that you will wake up. Okay, there is some question I want to ask you about the sleeping. The first one, Rasulullah, if he want to sleep, he will take the wudu before sleeping, even though if you slept, your wudu will break. What is the benefit? Understood?
Protection.
No more protection. When he starts sleeping, the no more protection. Understood? Because the sleeping will break your wudu. So what is the benefit from your wudu? Of course, it is sunnah, but just we would like to know what is the hikmah from the sunnah. You know, until Rasulullah, he told Bilal ibn Rabah, I saw, you know, sound of your legs in the your thoughts in the shurga. Okay? Like he is walking in the shurga and Rasulullah he heard. He heard it. Which means he is in shurga, he will enter the shurga. Why? He said, and Sayyidina Bilal, he asked Ya Rasulullah, why? He said, because you always taking wudu before sleeping. What is the benefit? Sham? What? What is the benefit? Yeah, actually Rasulullah, he want to remind us about the ibadah. Which means you can make your sleeping as the ibadah. When you take the wudu, like you enter the ibadah. When you make your niyyah, that is fi sabilillah, this sleeping is for fi sabilillah, and to become strong, to be strong for ta'at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, so that means you will have, that means all of your sleeping is ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like you are praying all the night. Understood? So every ta'at, if you want to do it like salat, you will have the wudu firstly. So now, when you take the wudu, that will remind you about the niyat of salat, about the sleeping. That you will make your niyat that is fi sabilillah. Just when you want to sleep, nawaitu at-taqawiyya ala ta'atillah. Itu saja. Nawaitu at-taqawiyya menkuatkan kepada ta'at Allah SWT dengan tidur ni. Dan tidur. Okay? The first question. The second. One of the dua mustajab, the time for dua mustajab, you know the times for dua mustajab, what is, when? Thuluth al-akhir min al-layl, the last 3 hours, okay, or end of the night, what else?
Jumu'at after Asa.
Jumu'at after Asa.
In the sujood.
Raining.
Traveling.
Puasa.
Rawdah.
Sujud. Rawdah.
Bain
al-adhan wal-iqamah.
Bain
al-khutbah. Bain al-khutbah. Bain al-khutbah. Di antara dua khutbah. Salat Jumat. What else?
Bain al-haramain.
Tengah tidur. Ada doa mustajab. Tengah tidur.
Tengah tidur.
Okay. How tengah tidur? Okay, this is your homework. Sahih Bukhari, hadith number 1154. 1154. Yeah. Okay, just read the hadith. Is the jawaban is over there. 1154. Read that hadith. Tengah tidur. Okay. Okay, the last one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the rest inside of the sleeping. But until now, the signs, they cannot catch the relation between rest and sleeping. If you want to be rest and relax, they will ask you to sleep, right? And after sleeping, you will become strong. How is the relation? Did you got it or not? There is some relax or rest. You can get it from the good place, from the nature, from traveling, many ways. But the main way, that is with sleeping. Okay, so what is the relation between rest and sleeping? Are they both of it is same or different? The rest and the sleeping is same or different? Different, actually. But how is the relation? Until now, no one he knows. When you sleep, just for 10 minutes, you become stronger. What is the secret thing inside of the sleeping that you will make it, you will make you stronger? There is some eating inside of the sleeping. What is the thing? What is the, you know, the secret that will make you strong? Understood? Maybe the medical science, they try to know. They try. But actually, these mu'jizat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How Allah put the rest inside of the sleeping. That's one. Okay, the last one also, how the jinn or how the shaitan will disturb you inside you, inside of your dream. Mm-hmm. Inside of it. Are they inside of your body or they enter or how? Also this one, you have to think about. Okay, these two things. Okay, this one, that's all, inshallah, we'll continue next week, inshallah. سبحان الله وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والعصر إنسان في خس إلى الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.